hear a lot of criticism towards us from that particular stance. In fact, sometimes even we as members of the church, when our hearts are so full, and we still have so much desire to embrace all and to have them have the same happiness we do, even sometimes we misunderstand that principle of the gospel, that that is an eternal doctrine of the law of Jesus. A few years ago, I love to run. I love to run marathons, and a few years ago, I decided to run a marathon up in the mountains. It's called the Powder Face 42. 42 is Canadian for 26. So just 42 kilometers is 26 miles. So I went to run this 42-kilometer race through the mountains. And there was only 16 of us dumb enough to do this race. So off we went, because we had to run through two mountain passes. Now most of the time I can run a marathon in about 3.5 hours. But this one took me about 8. It was quite a bit harder. At mile 12, we came to a station and we signed our names, saying that we are willing to die and that you're not responsible for it. We signed our names at that point because they needed to, that was a checkpoint, because we were not going to see anybody else until mile 22. For 10 miles, we were going to be on our own through these mountain passes. As I ran through these mountain passes, I came to all throughout the mountain, this trail, there was trails going all over the place. At each one of those trails, there was a little blue flag. And on that little blue flag, it said Powder Face 42. And so I knew which fork in the road to take. I was so grateful, brothers and sisters, that somebody went before me who knew the trail back and put a little flag at each point in the trail that I had to make a decision. Brothers and sisters, it would have done me no good to say the following when I got to one of those little flags. Finally, I got to the little flag and said, well, that's a little prejudice towards the other trail. And where would I be? I'd still be running. I'd still be trying to find my way home. And we need to understand that Heavenly Father has not left us without direction. He has given us prophets and apostles and those who have gone before, both ancient and modern, who have put up the flags. They're right there in front of us. There isn't any question, brothers and sisters, because of the eternal truths, like the family, the proclamation on the family is one of those little blue flags that is there for us. So we don't have to make this, we don't have to try to figure out which path to take. We already know, because God's told us. And so it's not about prejudice or about being bigots or anything like that, or having a bias against everybody, anybody. This is about Heavenly Father trying to help you and I return home to Him and become one. This is about exaltation and eternal life. This goes far beyond what's happening here on this world. And it has eternity written all over its pages for us. As we try to move forward and as we look for those little blue flags, every 6 months, you get them. You come to a crossroads, they're right there, the blue flags. And brothers and sisters, one of the things we're asked to do right now is sometimes we need to be the ones waving those flags. We have the courage to stand up and say, this is the right way, and this is what we need to do. Thank you, brother. Appreciate that. Anybody else? Yes, thank you.